they're both identical for size. You could have it so you cut it down in Windows Media, but we figured why strain it any more than you have to.
And we've got other content other than these, like bike cams.
Yeah, there's various different ones. I mean, this is just clips and highlights of the thing, but there's a UDP unicast, there's a UDP multicast. Giving it the address and the multicast address and the port number that you need. That is then cleared into the data box as a packet mode service, which then has Reed Solomon put onto it, become an enhanced packet mode. DMB is basically put onto users the H.262 for MP4 video, and at the minute we're using the AAC Plus audio recording. That puts it into an MP2 transport stream with all the various pack tables and everything it needs to identify it, and they have all their own PID numbers and all the syncing for visual speech and that. Comes out of ESI and it's just put straight onto the data mix as ESI.
The various forward error corrections that they're applying.
Yeah.
Added on the that's all done in Emacs, yeah. Isn't it? And for IP DAB as well as
yeah. So when, because
it's the IP DAB, that's the IP DAB, the big
yeah. T. Yeah.
And this uses the headphones as well.
Yeah, and that's the antenna. Now the new one, this lobster one, it's the one short of a few software tweaks, will go into service. It supposedly has a 6 to 8 dB better antenna, which from what we've seen will put its performance closer to this. But you can either click the TV button, which takes you into the menu, or press menu and broadcasting, TV. Now we've already searched, so it's already there. Because we've got it all fired up, we should start getting our pictures. We can turn the volume right down when we're doing the drives, because otherwise we've got the radio in the background, we've got the audio from these, and it just gets a bit. So when you see this, you don't know if it's frozen or not. That's the T-DMB. Now this usually takes a little bit longer to get started because it buffers about 5 seconds worth before it gets going. And because of that, this is the delay. So if you look at the two, there's about 5 to 6 seconds. This is behind that. Right. Two DMDs into the two quarters. But I'm not sure of the merit of that because we don't have the level of control that we thought we would with delaying them. It's literally the same as we get from putting the other DVD player up and just going like pause, one, two, three, four. Yeah. Personally, I think we could put
per second DVD.
Yeah, we've got DVD,
going down there. Absolutely, because what you want it within, if you can get it within about a second or so,
yeah
you'll be fine. And the fact that
well, the other thing you can do is if you've got somebody up at 5 green and you've gone out with someone here, you can refine it, spend an hour refining it, get as close as you can. But, you know, I mean, this has been playing on a loop constantly 24 hours a day, even though I've been playing out on service for 2 weeks now, without a problem. Now, our problem at the minute with this is it looks like these, because they've come direct from Korea, only have the B-SAC audio, so we can get decode the video quite happily. But the audio, we get nothing. This one, which is also a DMB, is a couple of seconds ahead of that one. And the only thing we can think of is with that being a phone, it's doing a level of buffering that we aren't fully aware of.
So in terms of video quality then, is this like the highest we can achieve?
This is the highest we can do with them both at the same level without filling up completely the mux. Select 3 here. Next. We just leave that as the
platforms that tells exactly what it's doing. It's going 48k a second tall with T-DMB protection, level 3 here, and it's taking 186 capacity units, which at the moment is taking up just over 14%. And the data, obviously, because they're both the same, is double that. And then we move that from the configuration because that's the old one at 4.
Yes, it says 4A.
So that then chugs along. Even though it looks like it's done it with the mouse, it hasn't. It's just finished it there, so we've only got the one data service now. So now we can click.
Percentage of the capacity taken by the IP, sorry, the DMB than the IP, and now data content has gone up from 28.7 to 36.
Yeah. All saved?
I'm just going to save it now.
Yeah.
So we save it. So now the next time that configuration, to the video is recalled, those are the settings that the video services will have. If we just left it automatic, do that at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, but that's a bit silly, we want to do it now. So, we go on to configuration manager, which is currently in automatic. First we'll be changing the mode to manual. And then we go reconfigure. And that is the one we've worked on. We click OK. We get a screen up that says the reconfiguration has been scheduled. And we shouldn't see any disruption on this. The reconfiguration is done. They're obviously still working.
We've still got the audio.
We've still got audio for Smash Hits. Signal 2. And the last one, Boosty Store. So all five audio sources are still intact. The last thing we do, change mode back to automatic. And it's done.
Then since we got it yesterday, we just stuck the mag mount for the new video thing just on the front corner, so it's actually pointing like that. And that's pretty much it. Just sit with the laptop on my lap.
And you're finding the GPS is able to get enough, it's not shielded by the...
BBC Radio Stoke. Travel. Helen in Hartfield's round. She used to have, used to be a domestic, and she called her two cats Mop and Brush. Love that one, Helen. More cat and dog names after the news and sport.
Oh. I'm Slip Road to Lightwood Road. We got some trouble if you're using the M6 southbound heading towards the West Midlands. Starts to slow down from junction 12 at the A5 in Gailey down to junction 9 at Wensbury. And also we've got a lane blocked off because a car overturned earlier on about 20 past 1 this afternoon. Inside lane.
Oh, come on, we should have the BBC National down.
Not the same day like that.
Yeah. It also doesn't greatly help that it's trying to show a fairly large screen size on a really small one.
Nice one, Frank. That's excellent.
Well done.
the other guy carrying the phones goes one's field, other's field.
Yeah, how do I do that?
Put it on and drag. Well, you're at the edge of the thing now.
Oh, do I do that? Oh, I see.
Well, let's worry about that in a short while. Let's give it a... Make the DAB fail, T-DMB okay, MPEG-1 layer 2 audio music out fail, or intermittent. Yeah. And bit error rate, 1.4 times 10 to the minus 1. Okay, let's walk to the end of that in a straight line then. Getting much better, of course. Surprise, surprise, to be here. But still quite
IP DAB's back now.
IP DAB return.
What signal level you got?
We got neg 54. And we got signal to noise ratio 33.
Back
to neg 65.
TDMB's
working,
every
DAB went.
26 dB, signal
to
noise ratio.
It's fine.
TDMB.
TDMB.
Well, that's just come back,
then.
Huh?
Yeah, every
DAB's
come back.
What's the
BER? Well, it's not even registering, it's that good.
Yeah.
Signal strength of neg 57.
Yeah.
A signal to noise ratio of...
IP DAB's in and out.
Yeah.
It's right on the limit. Gone.
Yeah.
No. I think something's come. It's about a loop with the audio.
Some good readings.
Yeah.
And if you can, you know in your little book you've got where you did the failure modes and that?
Yeah.
Try and write down what you've got here as well for failure modes and so forth.
Yeah.
That'd be really good.
Might be also worth asking them if they have a floor plan of this place as
yes,
well.
Yes, absolutely.
Well, and just as well.
Yeah, just.
Sit, stand up there.
Nice one.
So you're saying it might not be a good idea, but you carry this thing.
Lots of big windows. We can do a lot of work in this building.
You know, how many people have you ever seen that were in ketchup members on the clock? And given from how many... 3 minutes
to reach the point. Well, there, guys. Cheers. Check your video recording, Paul. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Right then, it's 1:34, and time for the news headlines on BBC Radio Stoke. A mum from Newcastle has made a dash to the south coast to try and find her missing daughter. Amy Pegg has been missing since Tuesday. Mother Wendy Beach believes she's heading to Brighton. Some Labour MPs are expressing dismay that the Prime Minister won't be announcing a timetable for his departure at this month's Labour Party conference. And detectives investigating the murders of a mother and her three children in Greater Manchester have arrested the woman's husband. More on all those stories at 2 with Phil.
Your eyes are blue.
Just round about.
Phone
rings.
Easy.
Yeah.
Follow you.
Phil. It's not known, the other one, the IP's a bit rubbish. Useless, I would say. Yeah, I think useless is the technical term. It's difficult to tell because it was pretty crap yesterday. But, well, let's put it this way, we're just coming out the middle of Newcastle and heading up to just past their staff. Council demo,
towards Alsages. We've got signals still in the mid-50s and the IP down to the main road.
The carpenters, they long to be close to you by Macarac and David. Before that, the air that I breathed from the hollies, and the first one kicking off on Love in the Afternoon, starting with Ben Midler's Wind Beneath My Wings. Lovely. And we'll do another one on Monday. Okay. Oh, this is interesting stuff.
Tense, nervous, headache.
Loads of callers trying to get through to praise and grumble.
Stressed, irritable.
I'm afraid that's about all we've got time for this week.
Need fast, effective relief? Then try the unique power of Praise and Grumble 24/7. When you can't have your say on a match day, you can let it all out by leaving us a message. Just call 01782221215 and talk about your club at any time of the day or night. The best of your messages could be heard in the Friday football phone-in on BBC Radio Stoke, so don't wait till the weekend. Praise and Grumble 24/7 on 01782221215.
BBC Radio Stoke with Nick Robbins.
Another 10 minutes really before we finish with what's the question. Yeah, this is the answer thing. I love that. We'll have to come up with a proper name for that, you know, because it's beyond me. The answer is Smith. Hang on a minute, what is today's one? I've forgotten it now. This is a silly thing, isn't it? Well, can't, no, that, yes, that's right. The answer is Smith. What is the question? That's right, it was Jones yesterday. I'm getting all confused.
Yeah.
What if, the answer is Smith. What is the question? If you know, you've got about 10 minutes, yeah, and then any second, in fact, after the next tune, we will launch the qualifying question for today's Clueless Quiz. But first, it's Queen, you know.
Ask him if he ran Paul Rasmussen.
The answer, Smith, what is the question?
Off now.